Welcome to Emergency Chaos, where we provide tips and tricks to make you a better ER nurse. Today, we are going over two common medications used in the ER, Versed and Ativan, otherwise known as Midazolam and Lorazepam. They are both benzodiazepines. So when would we use one over the other? Stick around to find out. So benzodiazepines are sedative medications that slow down the central nervous system. In the ER, we are often giving them for seizures, alcohol withdrawal, sedation for combative patients, sedation for intubated patients, and sedation for procedures, among other things. Now, what are the key differences between the lorazepam and midazolam? Midazolam is fast on and fast off in comparison to lorazepam, who works longer, meaning its effects remain for a longer time frame. Now, from what I've been taught and from my own experiences, midazolam intramuscular onset is approximately 15 minutes, while lorazepam intramuscular onset is approximately 30 minutes. Midazolam IV is within 5 minutes, while lorazepam IV is within 10 minutes. Now for duration, midazolam is approximately up to 2 hours, while lorazepam can be up to 6 hours. So now, let's say that you have a patient coming in for seizures. We know that benzos are a good first-line medication for seizures. Why might your provider pick one over the other? Let's start by asking, does the patient have an IV, or will you be able to obtain IV access relatively quickly? If you do have an IV or are able to get one super quick, lorazepam, aka Ativan, will be the chosen agent as its effects last longer, meaning you're gonna have longer seizure protection because it can last up to 6 hours. However, if you have no IV access, midazolam or Versed intramuscularly is given because it works quick, which hopefully helps break the seizure. Then once the seizure is broken, IV access can be obtained, so other medications like Keppra, Dilantin, or valporic acid can be administered if needed. Now, what about alcohol withdrawal? Which agent would work best? We know that withdrawal is not a short process, so we want an agent whose effects are prolonged, such as lorazepam, which again can last up to 6 hours. Now, on the other hand, what about with procedures, where you want the patient sedated during the procedure, but ideally back to normal as soon as it's done? Midazolam is ideal because it starts to work fast so the procedure can get underway, but it also doesn't last a long time. So when the procedure is complete, the patient can start going back to their normal baseline. The main complications we need to watch out for as nurses are respiratory depression and decreased mentation to the point where the patient cannot protect their own airway. If you are ever giving a benzo IV, your patient should be on a monitor to be closely observed. With respiratory depression, it primarily occurs when it's giving too fast. Again, with respiratory depression, it primarily happens when you give it too fast. So when you do give it, you need to ensure that you're administering it nice and slow, ideally over 2 minutes, so the effects come on gradually. This is particularly important for your elderly patients, again, because benzos can have a stronger effect on them. So give it nice and slow. Remember, you can always give more of a medication, but you can't take it back once it's given. I personally believe the safe thing to do if you are ever giving benzos IV is to have respiratory equipment such as a bag valve mask and suction readily available. Patients react differently to medication, so I feel safer when I'm prepared just in case something happens. Thank you so much for watching. I would really appreciate a like and a follow, and if you learned something today and would like to help support the channel, please consider getting the mini book I put together on Amazon. The link will be in a pinned comment below. As always, you should continue nurturing your curiosity and continue learning daily. With that in mind, please watch my other videos, and I've also listed my favorite ER nursing related books in the description text and in the comments as well. So when you get a chance, please check them out. And if you've learned something recently while at work that may be helpful to other new ER nurses, please consider sharing it in the comments so that we can all benefit and help each other out. Thank you. And as always, teamwork makes the dream work. And here at Emergency Chaos, we are proactive, not reactive.